seeing what's new in the world of law, finance, business, and politics. Mr. Whitaker, you want to come up? Yes, thank you. Sir, you want to come up? Yes.
I kind of forgot to do that. I'll do six next time. If you want me to.
You forgot, huh? You were in the middle of the semester and you forgot.
I did.
Well, come on up because you can stay for the question. You've got the homework, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I got it.
Right. Come. We need to hear your articles. Muhammad, you got articles? We'll rely on Mr. Whitaker. You come up. Mr. Whitaker, what's new?
Basically, the unstable income with rain and customer tips.
Okay, sir. All right, thank you. Let's return to agency. Who's the last question that we covered? Can you recall, sir? The last question?
What were you saying? 41 or something like that?
42?
Okay.
Okay, we're going to write a few more statements. Mohammed.
Chairman, this court principle authorizes Raven to act as an agent in securing a contract and purchase of some claim by the documentation from the land that you back on behalf of the principal. Enter into a contract with Sam to purchase the paper. If Jim approves the contract with Sam, which of the following is correct? Quote, the upon learning that Jim is the principal, Sam may elect to hold either Jim or Raven liable on the contract.
Okay, what do you, what's our statement here? Who's writing on the board? Okay, I think we could say where there's an undisclosed principal, undisclosed fee. Okay, above it. A secured contract. Third party. One third party. Learns of P. She can hold either A or B liable. Agree with that, Mohammed?
Okay. Having like third parties learn about the principles, like this is the agent is revealing it by mistake, or like are there other ways like a third party learns that a principle exists or an agency relationship exists?
I don't know. They might stumble upon some paperwork. Someone might tell them. Any number of ways. Or sometimes the agent might slip up.
Right.
Okay. Next.
The dealer has been engaged by Lux that has acted as the agent for Lux and undisclosed principal. As a result of this relationship, Steel has a pay. Steel has the same five powers as the agent engaged by the school. It's like, if you have a undisclosed.
Or we could say A has implied powers and a disclosed and undisclosed. Relationship. But it doesn't matter whether the principal is disclosed or undisclosed, A still has implied powers. And my next question to you, sir, would be, what do we mean by implied powers?
That they can make decisions in whatever they do.
On what basis?
On
Fly power, sir. Chris? Rita?
Power, which is implied. Fly power.
Power, which is implied, okay.
Alright.
Whatever is deemed necessary to fulfill the purpose of the agency.
Mm-hmm.
It might not be explicitly stated. Yeah, this would imply powers.
Is that the same as implied authority?
Actions deemed necessary to fulfill agency purpose. Yes, if there was some dispute as to whether it was necessary or not.
Mm-hmm.
But in most agency relationships, it's almost impossible to outline or enumerate every possible thing that that person must do.
Mm-hmm.
So yes, it has to be reasonable. Next, number 44. Yes, sir. What's your name again?
Eric.
Eric.
Yeah. Davidson.
You didn't get radio, did you?
What? My test?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, I did. Davidson is the agent of Myers. If you review it, Myers is an undisclosed principal. Davidson contracts with Wall to purchase 30,000 tons of coal at $20 per ton. Which the following is correct. I said, hey, if Davidson acts outside the scope of his authority and enters into his contract, Myers cannot ratify the contract.
Okay. This one's pretty straightforward. Give me a statement, Eric.
I mean, the agent can't act outside of the...
Alright, let's start this way. Let's define ratify. What does it mean to ratify?
Like to agree on the puzzle? Or essentially?
Well, what kind of sort of, yes, sir.
Is it to change the original agreement?
Sign,
yes. Approve? Yes. All of those statements are true, but are half-truths. Not quite fake truths, but half-truths. All right. Okay, it's good said. Beg your pardon? Yes. Subsequent, this is the definition. Subsequent approval prior unauthorized acts. Okay, now back to you, Eric.
Okay, am I doing the next question or am I giving a statement?
You're giving a statement.
Acts outside of the scope of his authority, and he doesn't have to ratify the contract.
Okay, if A acts outside the scope of his authority and entering into a contract, he cannot ratify.
Like, not at all, there's no option.
No.
Okay.
So, you want to say that again for our.
Please.
Thank you, sir. If A acts outside the scope of authority upon entering into a contract, he cannot ratify the contract.
breaches, covers made after learning the agreement from Barn and Dieter, elect to recover from either Barn or Dieter.
What are we saying here? I think basically we're just saying that a third party
has the right. Jason Manufacturing, who's the principal, right?
Yes.
All right. Knowing that if it tried to purchase a property, there would be a substantial increase, so an employee Kent. Okay. Kent to act as his agent without disclosing that Jason was the principal. Okay. Kent's authority was evidenced by a sign signed by the proper officer. And Kent entered into a contract in his own name to purchase the lot, giving Peter a negotiable note. Jason Kent. Jason also disclosed his identity as Kent's principal to Peter. Statute of fraud. What about the statute of fraud?
If you were dealing with land or property, you could be selling the money, put in a written contract.
Okay, there are certain transactions that have to be in writing. And if you're dealing with land, property, transfer, real estate, it has to be in writing. So here, to agree with an oral authority, would not have been enforced. All right. Next.
Magnus Real Estate Developers Incorporated wants to acquire certain tracts of land in Marshall Township for its build a shopping center complex. The complex is called Magnus Engage Next to Sophisticated Real Estate Developers.
ratifies the contract.
Of the agency
and B. Okay, as far as A, why is he not liable? Why does it have to be in writing? Yeah, and what's that statute? Statute of frauds. All right? So we mentioned the statute of frauds covers real estate transactions or real estate of property or real property. But it also applies when contracts are not performable within 1 year. Okay, and how do we determine whether the contract is performable within 1 year? No. What do we look at?
How long is it going to take?
We look at the day that the contract is executed. If it appears on the date that the contract is signed that it cannot be performed within a year, or stated that it cannot be performed within a year, then it must be in writing. All right? All right. So you look at the date the contract is made. Now, this is different than saying if somebody enters into a contract, and when the contract is signed, it appears that reasonably it could be completed within 6 months. But for some reason, it's prolonging, it's extended out to like a year and a half. No statute of frauds problem. Because we look at the day that it was executed that it could have been performed in a year. See the difference? Yes? Eric? You do? A little bit?
Yeah.
Either you do or not.
No, I'm a little bit confused.
Huh?
I'm like a little bit confused. You're saying that like the contract you
Thank you.
might want to write this one down.
Is it, if you're silent, it's almost like you're allowed to have it, but you're not stopping it.
I told you I wanted a Mercedes. You bring the BMW. I don't say anything. Park it, you leave it. I haven't said no, I haven't said yes, I'm just silent. My silence assumes that I accepted that. That's a substitute. Contracts. Principal P can ratify contracts. By silence. And a receipt. And retention of benefits. Ratification requires that the agent purported agent. Purported.
You are.
Purported. Agent. Indicates to the third party that P ratify the entire act of A and the ratification is retroactive.
62.
Simmons, an agent for Jensen, has the express authority to sell Jensen's goods. Simmons also has the express authority to grant discounts of up to 5% of list price. Simmons sold Hempel goods with a list price of $1,000 and granted Hempel a 10% discount. Hempel had not previously dealt with either Simmons or Jensen, which the following courses of action the Jensen property date. Since he received the property for $50 from Simmons only.
Okay. 53.
David, on behalf of Fixcore, enters a contract with SkyBook, that with SkyBook uses some computers, computer equipment to fix. David disclosed to Sky that she was acting on behalf of Fix. However, David had exceeded her actual authority by entering into contract with Sky. If Fix does not want to honor the contract, he will render that be held liable to Sky and put that pay if my parents are authority to buy Fix.
Okay. 64.
Ford is the vice president of purchasing for Creator Corp. He has authority to enter into purchase contracts on behalf of Creator, provided that the price on their project does not exceed $2 million. Vance, who is the president of Creator, is required to approve any contract that exceeds it. Ford entered into a $2.5 million purchase contract with Shady Ford without Vance approval. Shady was unaware that Ford exceeded his authority. Neither party substantially changed his position in their reliance on the contract. What is the most likely result of this transaction? A. Creator will be bound because of Ford's apparent authority.
Okay. 55.
Dill is an agent for Bid. As such, Dill made a contract for an which was not authorized upon which Mint has disclaimed liability. Sky has sued Mint on the contract, asserting that they had the apparent authority to make it. In considering the factors which will determine the scope of the apparent authority, which of the following would not be included? Said A, the express limitations placed upon the authority which were not known by Sky.
Thank you. Alright, thank you, gentlemen. The exam that we will have on Friday cover question 1 through 65. It will not be all 65 questions. On some of the questions, you will just be required to give an answer. Correct answer, A or B. On other questions, you will have to give the correct answer and tell me why. Okay? Which is basically what we've been doing with the statements here. Are there any questions?
How many questions?
50 or less.